Hi there. I'm using the fx-991EX scientific calculator from Casio. I've been using the emulator software right now. And what I'm going to show you in this video is how to enter statistics, one variable statistics, how to do the one variable calculations, and also how to visualize the one variable plot, such as a box plot or a pie chart or a histogram, using the QR code that is available on this calculator. So I have with me just an activity that is shared below in the description, and it has some preset data if you don't have your own data, but it's always more fun for the students to collect their own data. So if you have a way for them to collect data, you know, count things around the room, what's their ages, what's their shoe size, things like that, I would suggest doing that. I am going to use this data right here. And this is the heights of players in a football team. So to enter data, so here's the calculator. It is a menu-driven calculator. So you see here, using the direction buttons, I can go through the different menus. So this is where you would calculate, do complex numbers, matrices, vectors, and what we want is the statistics menu. So I'm going to go to that menu icon. Or I could have just hit, if you see this number here in the corner, 6, I could have hit 6. So once I get where I need, I'm going to hit the equal, which is the enter sign. And I want to do one variable statistics right now. So I'm going to choose 1. And it's going to basically send up a section for me to enter my data. So here's my data right now. And I'm going to just simply enter it. So you enter the numbers. Once you've got the number, you hit the equal to basically set it. So let's enter these numbers. So if you're doing this with students, it's always much more fun for them to be collecting their own data and entering their own numbers. So, you know, they could measure their own heights, and these are measured in meters, but they could do it in inches, they could do centimeters, whatever makes sense for the students you have. So it also gets in that practice of measuring and entering data. But then they're comparing things that are the same. All right, so we've entered all the data. We have 11 numbers in our data set. So now I want to do the calculations. Now, technically, since I have it all written on paper, I could just go to the calculate, and actually, if I wanted to find the mean, the median, the mode, I could actually enter them by hand, right, do it by hand. But what I want is, since I'm in the statistics menu, I want to go to option, and you'll notice here I have different options. So here's my one variable calculations. Statistical calculations. If I scroll down, there's some more different things I can do. Let's go back up. What I'm interested in is the one variable calculation. So I'm going to choose 3. And here are my one variable statistics. So my means 1.78. And if we scroll down, you'll see that it has the max value, the quartiles, the number of things, the standard deviation, all of that. So that's very quick and easy. What I want to now show you is the visualization that is capable with the QR code that is available. So you'll notice over here under option, where we got these statistics to begin with, there is this QR. So if I hit shift right now, it's going to give me a visualization of this data. So this is nice, because sometimes it's hard for students to see this, so they could, if they had an internet and access or a QR app on their own phone that goes with their handheld calculator. So what you do is you hit shift, and then option, and it creates a QR code, a QR symbol. And if you had the app, you would scan it, and they would see it on their phone. But since we're in the emulator, notice it makes this separate window up here, which is basically a live link. So when I click it, the window that I was in is now going to be visualized. And so now I can see that data all at once in a much bigger screen. And then I also get a box plot that is automatically generated here. And so we can look at the, if you notice, the 5-number summary, that's what's in here. So we can explore this box plot and think about that. So that's a really nice feature of the fx-991EX calculator, is that you have the ability to visualize. And notice that you can send this to someone, you can print it, you can save it, you can use it in, you know, worksheets, however it is you want to use it. It's all available to be used and copy and paste it. So I'm going to go back to my calculator and my activity, and I'm going to hit all clear. That gets me back to the table. So another thing, so when we were in the statistics, the one variable statistics, that's when I did the QR code. So it took me to the one variable statistics in a graph. If I'm in the table and I hit the QR code, so now we're in a different position, a different place. We're in the actual table. And now if I hit the QR code, it's going to take me to a different visualization. So this time I have the table itself. So here they can see the table much clearer. The whole table comes out. And it's the box plot again. But notice I could change the visualization now. So I could change it to a circle graph. I could change it to a histogram as well. So different ways to look and see the data that you simply use that QR code. And notice it creates a new tab. So I can now toggle between. Here's my statistics. And here's the table, and now since I can send these and copy these, I can use them in different ways.